The past 200 years of research in science and technology has been overturned with a new approach on our ancient past. Only now are we beginning to realize that history is far more ancient than we have been led to believe. To us, this is the emergence of a new story, but it is one that we should have known all along. The missing links of our civilization is a major stumbling block as we progress forward in our understanding of the ancient past, but it is one in which we should be relieved is there, because throughout the ages we have been lied to. Only now is history beginning to make sense to us. Only now are we hearing the message of our ancestors. Just wait to hear this. As we go forward in history, we must learn to do something we haven't done before as a civilization regarding history. We must be honest and open, not only of the past, but also of the future, and we must teach our young today that this message must be upheld as to not repeat the closed society that thrived for thousands of years before the cracks began to creak and burst. You might ask the question of why now? Why, after thousands of years of suppression, are we only now making these discoveries, joining the dots and seeking more answers to a truth that feels like it's getting closer? But what happened to the ancients? We know a cataclysm happened by means of a comet strike and the Great Flood, but what triggered these events, and did the ancient people know it was coming? Have you ever heard of a guy called Milutin Milankovic? Well, this guy may have had some answers that have been overlooked. He accurately predicted what we are only now just learning, including a shift in the location of Earth in space, which he realized that this causes warming and cooling of the Earth that affects the ice caps and essentially proves that global warming is not a man-made event. Today we can't confirm this in modern studies. However, we still don't know the severity of these events, but what we do know that it pretty much happens every few hundred years and the severity fluctuates. And we are slap bang in one of these cycles right now. Milankovitch's goal was to calculate the temperature at different points on the surface of Earth at different times of year from axioms or first principles. That was a formidable problem. However, his initial calculations, published in 1920, gave results that were roughly in line with empirical data concerning early 20th century temperatures, and they thus immediately attracted the attention of meteorologists. In 1924, in collaboration with German meteorologist Vladimir Kupin and German geophysicist Alfred Wegener, who were then working on the causes of ice ages, Milankovitch extended his longhand calculation hundreds of thousands of years into the past to assess the effect of known regular changes in three astronomical parameters: the obliquity tilt of Earth's axis of rotation, the precision wobble-like movement of the Earth of the rotation axis, and the eccentricity, a measure of elliptical shape of Earth's orbit around the Sun. Those three parameters govern the amount of solar radiation that strikes Earth's surface at different latitudes and different seasons, possibly getting so severe that it has scorched certain structures in the past. Because they operate on different time scales, the parameters affect climate by interacting in a manner that sometimes increases and sometimes decreases the insulation at a particular location. Milankovitch worked tirelessly to construct the radiation curves at latitudes 55 degrees, 60 degrees, and 65 degrees north, which were deemed most important for affecting the advance and retreat of large-scale ice caps in the northern hemisphere. Curves for selected lower latitudes were presented in Milankovitch's mathematical climatology and the astronomical theory of climate changes in 1930. Both sets of calculations were contained within his masterwork, The Canon of 1941. Milankovitch's work was challenged during the 1950s and it soon fell out of favor. Most scientists thought he predicted temperature changes were too minor to choreograph the advance and retreat of glaciers. Perhaps more important, several European glacial deposits with ages that coincided with his predicted cool periods turned out not to be glacial deposits at all, and that development cast doubt on the principal evidence used to support his theory. His work was vindicated, however, in the 1970s. High-resolution studies of deep-sea cores confirmed that glacial periods, as reflected in seawater temperatures, precisely follow Milankovitch's predictions over roughly the past 1 million years. These studies provided evidence for cyclical climate change in the past, with periods of approximately 100,000, 41,000, and 23,000 years, coinciding with the astronomical cycles in eccentricity, axial tilt, and precession, respectively. The astronomically timed variations in solar radiation are now known as Milankovitch cycles. It seems that this was known in ancient times. They tried to warn us through the Giza Plateau in particularly, so we may see we are in a new age of discovery, but really it has all happened before to some extent. What do you guys think of this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.